Okay, assalamualaikum and very good morning. Okay, so today we continue our next chapter, okay, which is on the chapter 25, okay, manufacturing technology, and this is the part B lah, okay, what you have done in part A. So this is a continuous one, is a part B, okay. So okay, so in this one, you will learn on the subsection, which is on the vibration and chatter in machining operations. Okay, so basically this is quite important because this is the two parameters or effect to the machining process lah, basically. Okay, so basically a low stiffness of machine tools, okay, can produce a vibration and chatter of the cutting tools and machining components, and this is finally will affect the product quality, okay, such as poor surface finishing, okay, as shown in the figure here. This is the chatter mark, okay, so this is chatter mark happen on the surface of the twin part due to the low stiffness of tool, okay. So basically what you have to know, what I explained before, the components mean the cutting tools must have a high stiffness lah, so that during the turning process, okay, or cutting process, it will produce a very sharp and perfect cutting process lah, okay. So basically if the low stiffness of the machine tools is first, it can produce a poor surface like this, okay, and of course when it happen like this, it will have a loss dimension accuracy lah, okay, instead of you can achieve certain dimension accuracy due to the poor surface finishing, it will lose that target lah, okay. So of course it will create a premature wear, okay, due to frictions, high frictions, and chipping, okay. Chipping is something like this residue in this surface, okay, there's a chip, and failure of the cutting tools, of course, because if you have a very low stiffness and you stress the cutting tools to cut the workpiece, so we produce a failure lah, okay, and also the damage of machine tools component and noise from the high frequency lah. Of course, because you have a low stiffness, when you stress or you still make it to the maximum level of the cutting process, you will sometimes it can finally break the components, and of course during the process itself you will hear a very noise, a very high noise value lah, okay, you can, which is very annoying lah. Okay, so basically for the vibration part, okay, there's a two effects, okay. The first one is from the force vibration, okay, so the force vibration, and another one is self excited vibration lah. So there will be two part here. So what is the force vibration? It is caused by the periodic applied force from the machine tools, okay, for example the gear drive, okay, imbalance components for example, and also the cutting tool itself lah, okay. So the gear is the gear that drive the machine lah during the cutting process, and imbalance component is something when you mounted, you are not properly fix it, it will create, when it's rotate, it will create something of imbalance elements, okay. And of course the cutting tool itself, during the cutting tools, when it's give the force to do the cutting process, it will produce the forcing vibration, okay. So what the solution that you can do from this? The first thing is you can isolate or remove the forcing element. For example, you lower the lower or remove the natural frequency of the machine's components, eh? So maybe I can show you some of important thing here, okay. So let's say you have a, this is the graph of the amplitude, sorry. And this is the frequency. So let's say you have a natural frequency of here like 2 hertz, okay, which is the amplitude, certain amplitude, and you have a operating frequency, okay, let's say this is the natural frequency, the black one, natural frequency of the machine components, and another one you have a operating frequency, okay, which is the coincides, this is the operating frequency where the rotation of the spindle lah, okay, so it will coincide and it will amplify lah, amplify the amplitude, so it will cause the highly vibration lah, okay, the real output here, okay. So basically you have to isolate or remove the forcing element. Example, you lower the or remove the natural frequency of the machine or force frequency lah, that the thing that you have can do, or not you can change the cutting speed or tools geometry. So this is the cutting speed, okay, operating frequency, or we call it the cutting speed lah, okay. So this one you can change the cutting speed, for example from 2 hertz, this is too low lah, basically maybe you have a cutting speed of like 70 hertz for example. Maybe you can shift be upper and lower lah, maybe to become 50 hertz or to become 100 hertz for example, so that you not coincide with the natural frequency, so you can remove the unnecessary vibration amplitude lah, okay. So another things you can reconfigure the machine tools, okay. So this is what I explained before in the previous lecture. So you can reduce the bending moment, of course, and reduce the deflection of vibration lah. Okay, when you reconfigure, the structural natural frequency is different. Okay, so this one will become different. Okay, maybe I can draw in this blue color. So the natural frequency is become different value. So you can have a lower vibration lah. Okay. Okay, so what is self-excite vibration? Okay, so for the self-excite vibration, it also can call as a chatter. Okay, what you have the chatter mark here, caused by the interaction of chip removal process with the structure of the machine tools. Okay, so during the chip removal process, okay, when it's coincides with the structure machine tools, it will produce chatter mark lah, okay. So it have a very high amplitude and audible, okay, during the machine process you can hear right, chit 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 is something, the noise that you have will hear lah during the cutting process, okay. So the source is type of chip, this is discontinuous, okay, variation of friction and also the cutting feed lah. So due to discontinuous chip, so it will produce chatter, variation in friction, of course, okay, when you have different surface contour, it will produce a different friction, okay. And finally, if you don't use cutting fluid, then it become worse, okay. So basically for the material, you can use a hardened steel lah, okay, alloy, which is higher possibility compared to other aluminium lah, okay. And so basically this material will have a higher chance to create a chatter compared to the aluminium, sorry, okay. So for the, this is some term what we call it regenerative chatter, okay. So for the regenerative chatter, is most important due to the cutting surface with roughness and geometry disturbance from the previous cutting, okay. So you have a various depth and various cutting force, so it will create a regenerative chatter lah, okay. So for example, you can imagine you drive a car through the rough road, okay. So maybe this one can see the example of, okay, this is for example you have a, okay, this is the surface of the cylindrical, okay, and then when you want to cut it, okay let's see, this is the cutting tools, okay. Okay, you want to milling to cut the surface to this direction. So you imagine you drive a car, okay, through this direction, okay, and then okay, you drive a car through this direction at rough roads. That's what happened also in the machining process, okay. Okay, so solution, what you can do is the first thing, you can increase the dynamic stiffness of the system, the cutting tools holder example, okay, from the low stiffness here you increase the dynamic stiffness so it become more suitable. And also if they the you can damp the system itself, okay, you can do damping element to add to reduce the vibration elements, okay. So this is on the vibration. Okay, the next one is on the damping. Okay, so the damping is an important parameter also to be known for this machining process. Okay, so damping is a rate at vibration decay lah. Okay, so for example, you have a steel ruler. Okay, and you have a steel ruler, for example, then you try to make it down and then you release it, it will vibrate like this from the higher to the lower amplitude lah. Okay, another one is car suspension lah. Of course, when you go to the bump, you drive a car or motorcycle to a bump, and then you after you go through the bump, and then it will vibrate one or two cycle before it becomes stable lah. Okay, so this is basically the vibration, okay, which no damping element. And the red one is the which the damping element. You can see the amplitude is reduced a lot. Okay. Okay. So, these are two types, which is we call it internal and external damping. Okay. For the internal damping, is from the energy loss in the material during the vibration lah. Okay. An example, the composite material has the higher damping. Okay, this is internal lah, from the material itself. Composite have the higher damping than the cast iron. Okay, so you can see the figure here. This is the cast iron. You can see within this cycle, for 4000 cycle, you can see that the damping for the cast iron is reduced a little bit, but compared to the graphite, okay, or the composite, it reduced a lot. Okay, so during the time when it's reduced a lot, so the higher damping element is it. Okay. Okay, so why the composite have higher damping? Because of course the mixing of the different composite material, so it will become a more high damping lah, compared to just one fixed cast iron material like a steel, for example. Okay, so for the bolted joints, is consider the internal damping is a source of damping lah. Okay, so effectiveness depend on the size, okay, the size of the bolted joint, the location, number of joints, okay. So the movement of the unlubricated joints will increase the damping because the friction dissipate energy, okay. So if they are unlubricated joints, when the machining process is ongoing, so it will increase the friction, okay, because there is no lubricant, and it's basically it will increase the damping. Okay, so for the machine tools that have number of components, we increase the damping. Okay, this is the figure, for example, and resulting a low stiffness compared to the this is comparison that you can be done by impact testing method later on in the second semester when you learn vibration, and this semester also when you learn EML 331, there's a impact testing that has been introduced to determine the natural frequency of different material. Okay, so you can see here, okay, so this is the structure of the bed only. Okay, you can see the damping is very low. Okay, when you add on, you configure it with the bed and the carriage, bed and headstock, and finally you have a complete machining process. Okay, which is various mounting, okay, so that you will increase the damping. So it's a very simple concept. Okay, let's say you have a one block of steel, if of course when you it's a very high stiffness, okay, but low in damping. Okay, because it's like a solid thing. But if you have mounted it and with a different many bolts or nuts, and it will increase the damping and lowering the stiffness of the structure itself. Okay, and so that's that the effect on the bolted joints lah. Okay, so this another thing is called the external damping. Install this, you can install the external damping such as shock absorber in automotive lah. Okay, and for the suspension you also have the absorber, that's a damping, as we call the external. Also same goes to the machines, you can install the external damper to eliminate the vibration from the others machines lah. Okay, so specifically designed to isolate false vibration from the nearby machine or floor, basically installed at the foundation of the machine lah. Okay, this one maybe I can draw you. Okay, let's see, this is the machine A. Okay, and this is the floor lah. Okay, and this is the person that doing the machining process here. And another thing, there's a machine B, for example. Okay, there's another person doing the machine process here. So let's say you are doing at A, machine A, and your friend doing machining at machine B. So machine B create a more highly vibration. Okay, so from the vibration here, it's transferred to the floor and it's transferred to your machine. So that's why you have to have a like a damping mounting at the foundation, so that it can eliminate this vibration when it's transferred here. So the vibration transfer is very low lah, to be due to the absorption of the vibration from the materials. Okay, the damping materials. Okay, okay, the next chapter is on the high speed hard and ultra precision machining lah. Okay, so for the high speed machining, why is this important? Okay, because this is to improve the productivity, which a lower production cost lah. Okay, with the high speed machine, of course you can create a more products in one day, improve the productivity, and by that one machine only you can reduce the cost instead of you want to buy more lower speed machine. Okay, to meet the requirement of the product per day. Okay, so the range of cutting speed, as shown in the figure here, okay, this is comparison of conventional versus the rate crescent machining condition. So the rate crescent is the high speed machine. Okay, you can see that in terms of spindle speed itself is different, 3200 and 160 RPM. Okay, so this is the range, three type of range is considered high speed. When the machine is within this range, very high speed and also ultra high speed. So for this machine, rate crescent is considered as a 3200 and is labeled as a very high speed machine. Okay, so this is a consideration for the high speed machining process. Okay, what is the thing that, or the element that decide is the high machining, high speed machining lah. The first is on the spindle design, how the stiffness, the level of stiffness of the spindle, the accuracy, the cutting accuracy, and also the balance during the cutting process, how stable is it. Okay, the second one is fast feed drive, the motor. Okay, how fast your motor. Okay, is a decide the type of machining. Yeah, and then the inertia of the components, for example you have a lightweight material. Okay, that is considered as a high speed machining. Okay, the type of cutting tools. Okay, the tools holder. Okay, which using the carbide, diamond, etc. Okay, is considered of a high speed lah. Okay, and it's based of the workpiece, of course lah. The what is type of a piece, aluminium, maybe you don't need to use a very high cutting tools material, but for the steel, for example, you need to use the high level of cutting tool lah, is it carbide or diamond. And process parameter, the controller, how effective, how good the controller is it. Okay, the chip removal system lah, is very high rate chip removal lah. Okay, so that you are not worried about the rough surface or everything, because it's very high rate and it can remove all the chips very efficiently. Okay, So the second type of machining process is called the hard machining, okay, where this is the relationship, okay, the higher the hardness of the workpiece, the low machinability, okay. So this is problem of surface finishing, wear and fracture lah. This is what basically happen during the hard machining, okay, because when the workpiece, like you compare aluminium with steel, so the steel have a higher hardness, okay, and the machinability is lower, okay, compared to the aluminium. Okay, so for the solution, you must appropriate use the appropriate hard tool material, okay, and also you for the machining tools which is the high stiffness and high power lah, okay, this is the solution. You must use the machine tool which cutting tool with high stiffness, for example diamond or carbide, and which the power very powerful power amp of the machine tool to counter the anything of disturbance that affect the machine process. Okay, so example the automotive parts such as gear, pinions, using ceramic or ceramic cutting tools for a good damage accuracy, yeah, because gear and pinions is considered as a the steering gear, or you drive a car, the steering that connected to the your tire, basically there is a pinion and gear inside there. So this is very the safety part of the vehicle, so it must have a very accurate dimension and very highly performed material, so that it because this is safety of the car, so it must consider as a good finishing, okay. So the use of hydrostatic bearing for the spindle and the side slideware, this is on the chapter 23, one of the example, okay, using the hard machining process. Okay, so the hard tuning is basically 3 times faster lah, okay, compared to typical grinding, okay, so with a fewer operation and less energy to finish the part lah, okay, no need to have a more operation to complete the operation, and of course the less energy lah, okay. The final one is on the ultra precision machining, okay, so this is specific for the computer, electronic, nuclear and defense application lah. So mostly it's very high-end one, because for the computer electronics is very, it's sometimes micro and nano scale elements, you have a very high ultra precision lah, okay. And of course for the nuclear, for the defense application, okay, you must have a very because this is on the military, yeah, for the safety also you will have a very high end of products basically, yeah. Okay, so for example the fiber optic, okay, the memory disk, okay, is very small scale in the inside the memory disk. Now it's just a like a very very small memory disk. There's a very neat ultra precision machine, eh? And nano finishing and metrology, okay. So for another thing is the cutting tools, basically using a crystal diamond only, eh? It's called a diamond tuning. No other cutting material, just a diamond, okay, the most highly end material for the cutting tools, okay. The workspace material including such as the copper alloy, silver gold, infrared material and plastic too. For like infrared material is for the defense application, silver gold is basically on your computer, all the chips, everything is done in the gold material, right, okay. So the machine tools such as the spindle and tool holder device are built in the high precision, stiffness, okay, low thermal expansion, and locate in this clean room, dust free, and also under temperature control, okay. Of course the machine tools must very high precise, okay, highly stiffness, okay, no effect on the thermal, and in the clean room lah. So you need a special suits to goes to do the machine process inside the clean room, okay. So the internal and external vibration source must be avoided. There is no consideration for this lah, okay. The vibration is a must to be avoided, okay. So this is the buyer, okay, from 1940 and until 2000, how the machining process have been advanced. Okay, this is machining accuracy improvement using ultra precision machining technologies. Okay, there's some of the process. You can see the turning milling machine, CNC machine. Okay, what we learn here now, the lapping, honing, boring. Okay, the precision grinding, high precision, ultra precision machining is at here. Okay, so you can see the machining accuracy from the 110 micron for the CNC machine. For the ultra highly precision machine, is go up to 0.01 micron. Okay, the process of the finishing. Okay, and also there's more advanced technology we call ion beam machining. Molecular manipulation is up to atomic lattice distance lah. Okay, this is very I cannot imagine on how it can be done, but this is actually can be happen lah. Okay, but as of now it's going to a one nanometer only lah. Okay, maybe later on in 10 years time it can go into the atomic level. Okay, but we don't know how. Okay. Okay, so this is another question that frequently been asked during the test or exam. So give the four methods to reduce the vibration chatter in machine operation. Okay, so you have to think about it. What is the answer? Okay, so you can go back to the previous slide. Okay, on is the what the solution that can be done to reduce the vibration and chatter lah. Okay, on the solution and also the solution lah. Okay, so basically you can remove the forcing elements, change the cutting speed. Okay, reconfiguration, increase the dynamic stiffness, damping the system. Okay, that's some of the solution that you can done. Okay. Okay, so going to the next, or what I call the final one on this chapter. Okay, so this one is on the machining economics. This involves some of calculation for you to be done. Okay, so for the machinings, there's a factors of cost. Okay, there's six factors in machining economics. Okay, the first one is cost on the machine tools. Okay, of course you want to do machining, you must buy a machine. Okay, the tool device, feature, cutting tools, all the thing lah. Okay, for the machining. And the second one is on the labor. Okay, that you need to pay lah, the labor. Okay, how many person that involved for the machining, even though it's a fully automated, but you still need person or labors to control, to set up the controller of the CNC machine. Okay, or maybe in the future robot can do for it lah. Okay, and the third one is time required to set up the machine for operation. Okay, of course before that's the thing that I said before lah. Okay, how long how complicated the your products, and it's need more time to set up in the machine lah. Okay. And the next one is material handling and movement. Okay, during the process of machining, is there any problem? How you want to handle it? Okay, you move from the one a machine A to machine B, for example. The gauging of dimension accuracy and surface finishing. Okay, something that involve when you after some of product like the safety one, what you call before this on the pinion or gear, you need some of the additional surface finishing process. Okay, there is a lot of cost there. And also the cutting and non-cutting time. Of course, after you done the cutting, like maybe the 30 minutes of cutting, and then there's a period to the machine to release the heat and to take time to for the next process. Okay, the rest time for the machine, because machine also you cannot stress it in the full load, because it is will not long lasting. Okay, you need also to have a good maintenance of the machine. So of course there will be cutting and non-cutting time for the material. Okay, the machine process itself. Okay, so this for the economic analysis, this additional factors cost is based on, okay, some of additional factors and costs versus on the tolerance and surface finishing. Okay, this like a spindle length varies with the various tool changer. For example, you need additional works to set up your spindle because of the various length. Okay, maybe cannot be done automatically in the machine. And of course, when you need additional surface finishing, that we add another cost lah. Okay. And another one is the machining process to be robust and under control. For example, you need to do a very ultra precision machining that have a proper control of temperature lah. Let's say your CNC machine just inside our workshop compared to it put under the aircon room that is very proper that can control the temperature. That's the different thing lah. Okay, at the workshop maybe it's quite hot, but at the proper control temperature room is better lah. Okay. Okay. So for the cost, okay, the next one, how do you want to minimize the machining cost and time per piece? Okay. So the total machining per cost, what we call it the CP, can be calculated using the following equation. Okay, CP equal to CM plus CS plus CL plus CT. Okay, so what is the CM? Okay, actually all these six cost factor is translate into this more simplified form for these four elements only. Okay, the first is the machining cost. Okay, the CM. CS is the setup of cost for machining, mounting as fixture and tools. Okay, but we have the time required for the setup, okay, material handling. Okay, so the cost for loading, machine handling, the non-productive one. Okay, okay, the first one on the machine cost, of course lah, during the machining process, what is the cost involved? Okay, the before the machining process, the setup, the cost of loading, machining handling, which non-productive cost. Okay, this is the like a cutting and non-cutting time. So what is the cost involved? Okay, because you sometimes you material handling is something that actually is not involved, is important, but not the include in the overall machine process lah, because it's a that you want to handle machine like to move one from one part to another machine. Okay, this is something that maybe unnecessary, but you have to include it as a cost as a in the overall total machine process. Another thing is on the tooling cost. Okay, tooling cost is basically 5% of the total machining operation cost. Okay, so this is first equation that you have to know. Okay, just a simple direct forward. Okay, like cost A, CM, CS, CL, and CT, you can add all and come a total cost. Okay. Okay, come to these two important equations. Okay, the first one is the how to minimize the cost of machining. Okay. Okay, so this is called VOC lah, because cost. Okay. So the optimum cutting speed for the minimum cost, VOC, can be calculated using the equation 2 lah, 2 and 3, because 3 you have the symbol inside this, so you have to calculate this first. After that you get the value, and then you can insert to the overall equation lah, VOC. So what is the parameter involved? The first one is the tool life constant. Okay, what type of tool that you use? Okay, the cutting tools like carbide, for example. What is the this like fixed value of tool life constant? Okay, so basically this value is given, and then labor cost. Okay, per hour LM. Okay, here what is cost for the labor, the overhead charge. Okay, the thing that you have to include also, the burden rate, overhead charge, BM. The exponent value depends on material. Okay, the exponent value depends on material and is based on the material that you want to the workpiece material lah. Okay, what is the lifetime, okay, the exponential value of the materials. And also the numbers of edge of face that used for the insert mean that when you want to do machining for the four face of the material, for example, the insert is the cutting tools, the cutting tools when you have the workpiece and then you want this surface and also this surface as an insert to the cutting tools to do the process of cutting process, and then there is a consider as a in the cost also, okay. And time required to change the insert, okay, from cutting tools one to cutting tools two, what is the time required? Depreciation of the insert, okay, this also considered the cost for the insert, and time required to index the insert. So each time you want to change the insert, they will be indexing in the computer. So this is also the involved the cost, okay, for to get the optimum cutting speed in term of minimum cost, okay. Then another equation where you have to get the optimum cutting speed in term of maximum production time, okay. So when you produce one product with a minimum cost and maximum production, that's the best thing that you can get from the product. Mean that you reduce the cost, but you still can produce the many of the products, okay, maximum production time, okay. So this is another question that considers, because this is quite simple compared to this one, okay. This is all the parameters here directly insert to this equation lah. It's a direct forward equation, okay. So this is basically goes back to equation number one here. When you have a machining cost CM, CF, CL, and CT, how you can plot the graph to get it can relate to these two, optimum cutting speed with the minimum cost and optimum cutting speed with the maximum production. Okay, so for example, for the cost, this is the total cost CP. Okay, is equal to machining cost plus tool cost plus non-productive tool change cost plus the non-productive cost and plus tool cost lah. Okay, so CM plus CS plus CL plus CT. Okay, so for the cutting speed that we want to calculate here, this is the graph of total cost. Okay, cost per piece. Okay, so for this curve, you must get at the lowest point. Okay, the lowest point. What is the cutting speed? So this is total cost. You get the lowest cost, okay. And what is the cutting speed for the production? Okay, the machining process. Okay, and also another one is on the time. Okay, time required, which is productivity. Okay, so what is the minimum time? Okay, this is the curve of the time. Okay, for the machining, you have cost, you have time of machining lah. For the tool changes, you have the cost, also you have the time for the tool changing. Non-productive cost also you have cost and also you have time. But for the tool cost, of course you have cost of to buy the tools only lah. You no need time to do the machining because there's a tool cost. Okay, so this for the time is only three of them. Okay, and what you have to know is what the time required that for the minimum time for the maximum production. Okay, so the minimum cost per piece at this point and minimum time per piece at this point, we create a maximum production rate of the to produce the product, which is called a high efficiency machining range. Okay, so this range is called high efficiency machining range. Okay, so after this, I will show you the example how you can calculate this high efficient range, so that you can know what is the best for your production. Okay, the cost of machining part depends on surface finishing. The final surface can cause sudden increase of cost of. Okay, this is the cost. Okay, what you already get, but suddenly when you already complete the product, the machining of the products, sometimes your customer said that, oh, we cannot accept this quality of the product. You must do some additional surface finishing. So of course it will by changing this point, okay, it will suddenly increase the cost, because this is the minimum cost. Suddenly you go to this point, it will increase the cost, okay. This is because this is cost per piece here. Also the small changes in cutting speed, okay, because it involves the cutting speed, okay, when it's moved to here and it change the cutting speed, of course, from this point to this point, okay, resulting significant effect to the minimum cost and minimum time, okay. Let's say this one move to here, okay, it increase the cost and lowering the cutting speed, and when the cutting speed moving here, okay, it going higher time, okay, and higher cutting speed, and it will affect in term of minimum cost and also minimum time. Okay, that's a very important thing lah that you have to alert and know. Okay. Okay, let's see this example. Okay, so in the production of the machine valve, okay, the labor rate is $19. Okay, what is the labor rate? Okay, the symbol is LM. Okay, $19 here. And the general overhead is $15. Okay, overhead is the symbol BM, $15. Okay, so the tool is ceramic insert. Okay, okay, the tools, the cutting tool, ceramic insert with four face. Okay, the process is done in four face of the workpiece and cost $25. Okay, four face mean that, okay, you have the value of M equal to 4. Okay. Okay. M equal to 4. Okay. And cost of DI is $25. Okay. Take 5 minutes to change. Okay. Okay. TC 5 minutes change. C for change. And 1 minute to index. TI, I for index is 1 minute. Estimate the optimum cutting speed from the cost perspective, yeah, VOC, yeah, okay. So the tool's life constant given is C equal to 100, okay, and the value of VO is M per minute, okay. So you have this equation, the optimum cutting speed in the cost perspective, okay. So you already have the value of C here, LM is given here, $19 BM, $15 N. Okay, what is the value of N? Note that the ceramic tool that uses the ceramic insert can be get the value from table 21.3 here lah. Okay, there's many type of cutting tools. For this one, you use ceramic. So basically, for the minimum, we get the minimum one lah. The minimum value was 0.5. Okay, and then you have a this symbol lah, okay, you have to calculate this one first, okay. So all the values like M equal to 4, TC 5 minute, LM, BM, DI is all really given lah, okay. It's a very straightforward one, you just insert the value and you calculate it, okay. But the thing, you must make sure that your calculation is correct lah, okay. The TI 1 minute, okay. And so this is the how you can insert the value, okay. And then you get the of the symbol 82.75. Then after you get this value, then you can calculate the VOC, yeah, okay. Okay, using this C is 100, LMBM 19 plus $15, and value 0.5. Okay, 1 over N, 1 over 0.5 minus 1. Okay, the power of 0.5 here. Okay, the value that you get before 82.75 is insert here lah. So what you get, the value is the optimum cutting speed for the cost perspective is 64.1 meter per minute. Okay, so what you can plot here. Okay, okay, so basically so you have a graph A, sorry. Okay, you have the total cost here. Okay, so it's a value 64.1 M per minute. Okay, is the total cost lah, cost per piece, cost per piece. Okay, this minimum cost, this total cost. Okay, so this is the minimum value lah. Okay, so the next one, the next question is on the, okay, from the previous example that you get 64.1 for the cost per perspective, estimate the optimum cutting speed for the maximum production, which is VOT. Okay, you can go back to this equation. Okay, VOT, you already know the C value, the two left constant, the N, okay, the exponential value, the TC, time to change the insert, the M, the phase, the TI, time to change the index, and this is the exponential value. So you can calculate it. Okay, you can try by yourself here. Okay, what is the value of VOT? Okay, so from this, okay, you can get another graph. Change to the blue. Okay, so this is the VOT. Okay, so what is the value here? Okay, this is in terms of time. Okay, okay, and this is the speed lah. Okay, so what is the value? Okay, so the value here. Okay, so you have to find the value lah. Okay, what is the value here? Okay, later on you will get this effective the high effective machining range lah. Okay, from the optimum cutting speed for the cost and also the optimum cutting speed for the time. Okay, so you can calculate it, so you can have the value here lah. Okay, so let please try yourself. Okay, so for the last slide, just a summary. Okay, what we have learned for this chapter. Okay, the first thing is the machining centers are the most important machine tools lah, okay, nowadays, and their selection depends on the part complexity. Okay, how the complex is the products, okay, you want to machines, which decide the type of machine that you will use lah. Okay, the number and type of operation, okay, how many operations, number of cutting tools, okay, and also how accurate your dimension of the product will be. Okay, so this vibration and chatter are the important effects, okay, to be considered for the workpiece lah, dimension accuracy, surface finishing and tools. So when the vibration and chatter come to the your machines, it will affect the dimension accuracy, surface finishing and also the tools performance. Okay, so for to counter these two problems, stiffness and damping are the two important parameter lah to control this two. Okay, so finally, what we have done just now, the economics of the machine operation depends on the factors such as machining cost. Okay, there will be four important things: the total cost is equal to machining cost, setup cost, machine handling cost, and tool cost. So this relationship between the cost and the optimum cutting speed can be achieved by the minimum cost and also minimum time per piece. Okay, so I think that's all for this lecture. Okay, thank you very much. Okay.